Victorious. mangialo, paga mangialo, paga mangialo. Your kingdom shall reign over all the earth. Paga mangialo. Generations and generations shall know of your greatness. Woo! Paga mangialo. Reign, 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 Jesus. Reign, Jesus, reign. King of Zion, Lion of the tribe of Judah. Reign, 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 Gonyama. Reign, 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 Gonyama. Reign, 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 Gonyama. Over our situations. Because you are great. And the storms, they listen to you. And they obey. Because you are the maker of the very storms. Woo! So paga manjalo. Busanjalo. Ezimeni zetu. Busanjalo. We will sing of your glory, of your goodness, of your greatness forever. Yes, we will, Lord. That's why we serve a great.
We serve a great
and mighty
and mighty God.
We serve a great.
We serve a great
and mighty God.
Praise the name of our Lord Jesus. It's great to be with you once again, even as we enter into the three of the 21 days of lockdown in South Africa. I hope that you've been having a great time, in re-examining your life, reflecting in the first few days of 2020 and looking forward to better days ahead of us. Now, I actually want you to take note of this season. It's a special season. For example, I haven't had the opportunity to go on holidays in the last 12 years, but I mean, this 21 days long jam is giving me time to stay at home and spend time with my family and to spend time to reflect. I also want you to reflect. But there's something I came across, one of the, you know, postings that I received, and it's just about something that I explained, lockdown, you know, and I want you to take note of it and reflect over them these 21 days. Now, L stands for listen to God's voice and reflect, let go and let God. O stands for obey his words and his teaching, learn to obey God's words and his teaching. C stands for call on Jesus' name and become. Call on Jesus' name and become. N stands for know what is the purpose of all of this. There's a reason why we have the coronavirus at this time. There's a reason why God is creating a 21 days time for us to stay back home and reflect. Then D stands for dwell in his presence and do not panic. O stands for offer a prayer for everyone's safety. It's time for us to pray for one another and not just pray for ourselves alone. Then W stands for wait and be patient. These two shall pass. Please watch out before these 21 days comes to an end. I'll be bringing you a very powerful message titled, these two shall pass. And lastly, N stands for nurture our relationship with him. I'm praying that as you reflect over these words, you come out better after these 21 days in Jesus' name. Now, let's move into our teaching for today. It's our family Sunday. And as usual, as your spiritual father, I bring God's words to you. I bring God's blessings. But let's look at God's words that he wants to share with us this morning as we look at the subject, blessings in honoring our parents. blessings in honoring our parents. We take our Bible passage from Exodus chapter 20 and verse 12. Exodus chapter 20 and verse 12. I read, "Honor thy father and thy mother, that thy days may be long upon the earth, which the Lord thy God giveth thee." Exodus chapter 20, verse 12. Now let's take another Bible text, Ephesians chapter 6, verse 1 to 3. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 1 to 3. And I read, it says, "Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor thy father and thy mother, which is the first commandment with promise, that it may be well with thee, and that thou mayest live long on the earth." Hallelujah. Now let's look at a few things. How do we honor our parents? Number one, we honor our parents by obeying them. Obeying our parents. One major reason why we have to obey our parents is to honor them as our procreators. They brought us into this world. We must recognize that. So whatever instructions they give to us, we are expected to give heed to them. We honor our parents by obeying them and doing the things that give them joy and happiness. To honor and obey our parents is to honor and obey God. Praise the name of our Lord Jesus. Our parents may not come in our own generation. Our generation may be a faster generation, but please, they brought us into this world, and it's important that we obey them. Colossians chapter 3, verse 20. Colossians chapter 3, verse 20. The Bible says, "Children, obey your parents in all things." In how many things? In all things. "For this is well pleasing unto God." Don't be selective in the things that you obey your parents. Obey your parents in all things. And trust me, friend, the Bible says it is pleasing unto God. Hallelujah. In Proverbs chapter 1, verse 8, Proverbs chapter 1, verse 8, the Bible says, "My son, hear the instruction of thy father, and forsake not the law of thy mother, for they shall be an ornament of grace unto thy head, and chains about thy neck." Ornament of grace unto thy head, and chains about thy neck. Isn't that awesome, beloved spiritual children? It is important that we obey our parents. And as we do so, may every one of us be blessed in Jesus' name. Number two, we must take care of our parents. Take care of your parents. Make your parents happy by taking care of them, especially in their old age. Let's learn to constantly make telephone calls, send WhatsApp messages to our parents, send them money from time to time, check their well-being, and ensure that they are happy at all times. The Bible tells us in Proverbs chapter 23, 24 to 25, Proverbs chapter 23, 24 to 25, it says, "The father of the righteous shall greatly rejoice, and he that begetteth a wise child shall have joy of him. Thy fathers and thy mother shall be glad, and she that bear thee shall be rejoiced." I know that you are wise children. I know that you are righteous children. Make your parents joyful. Make them to rejoice. Why is they still on earth, not preparing for their funeral? So that, you know, they can be happy. As you do so, God will bless you in the name of Jesus. Number three, honor your parents by forgiving them. Our parents may have disciplined us. Our parents may have lacked. Our parents may not have sent some of us to school when we wanted to. But it's not enough reason to hate our parents. It's not enough reason to say negative things about our parents. Let's learn to honor our parents by forgiving them if they've hurt us in any way that we have learned as we're growing up. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 32 tells us, "And be ye kind one to another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake had forgiven you." God has also forgiven you. Also forgive your parents. Hallelujah. Listen to me. If you say negative things against your parents, there's a repercussion for it. There's a repercussion. And so just learn to forgive them. In Proverbs chapter 20, verse 20, Proverbs chapter 20, verse 20, the Bible says, whoso curseth his father or his mother, his lamp shall be put out in obscure darkness. That will not be your portion in Jesus' name. No, none of you desires that. I don't desire it for you. So I want to encourage you, if any of your parents did anything to you, forgive them and it will be well with you in Jesus' name. So what are the blessings that come from honoring our parents? Number one, long life. Long life. Our days on earth are long when we honor our parents. Exodus chapter 20, verse 12, B passes, that thy days be long in the land the Lord has given you. I'm praying for every one of you. This land will not consume you. As you honor your parents, your days on this earth and wherever you go shall be long in Jesus' name. Number two, that it may be well with you. That it may be well with you. In Ephesians chapter 6, verse 2, the Bible tells us that as we honor our father and our mother, honor our father, our parents, that it shall be well with us. Everything we do, it will be well with our marriage, well with our business, well with our career, well with our ministry, well with our profession, as we honor our parents. I'm praying for you, it will be well with you in the name of Jesus. And thirdly, and the last blessing from this for today's message is irreversible blessing. There are blessings that can be reversed, but when you honor your parents and they bless you, nobody can reverse it. We saw what happened in Genesis chapter 27 when Isaac blessed Jacob. He couldn't reverse it, even if it was Esau's blessing. Praise the name of our Lord Jesus. And the pronouncement of Jacob upon all his sons in generations after them, those pronouncements, whether blessing or curse, they stood. And I am trusting that your blessings will not be reversed in the name of Jesus. So honor your parents. A prayerful parent will make your experience great progress. As you honor your parents keep blessing you, those blessings will show in your life, they'll be irreversible in the name of Jesus. So this today I want to pronounce blessing upon you, but trust me, you must begin by honoring your parents. A lot of you have honored me so well in this church. A lot of my spiritual children, I saw a lot of your hand when I turned a year older last month. You honored me with gifts, with prayers, and I'm here today from out of my heart to bless you. I want to ask all of you, wherever you are in your homes, hold the hands of your children, and I'm going to pronounce the blessing of God upon you as my spiritual children, for honoring me in time past and honoring me now, honoring me for listening to this message, and God Almighty will bless you mightily in the name of Jesus. Let us pray. Father, behold my spiritual children that have honored me. Behold, these your children that have honored and keep honoring their parents. This day, O God, I pray that you open the heavens. And in blessing, you will bless them in Jesus' name. Please, Lord, I pray in the name that is above all name, bless them with long life. Bless them with all that they find their hand to do. Let it be well with them in their going out, in their coming in. In the name of Jesus, this day, O God, a blessing that no man can reverse, I pronounce upon each and every one of you in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare, blessed shall you be in your going out. Blessed shall you be in your coming in. Blessed shall be your body. Blessed shall be the fruit of your kind. Blessed shall be your work. Blessed shall be your family. Blessed shall be your children. Blessed shall be your going out. Blessed shall be your coming in. Blessed shall be your career. Blessed shall be your business. In the name of Jesus, blessed shall be all that you put your hand to do in 2020. So shall it be, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Let somebody shout hallelujah. I hope you have been blessed with the message of today. My prayer is that the Lord will perfect all that concerns you in Jesus' name. We are now going to be collecting our tithes and offering. As you do so, the Lord will increase your finance in Jesus' name. To give your offering, kindly EFT to the following account: The Redeemed Christian Church of God, The Ambassadors. Net Bank, account number 1043859004. For offering and Standard Bank account number 02160-4711 for tithe. Again, the Redeemed Christian Church of God, the Ambassadors, NetBank account number 1043859004 for offering, and Standard Bank account number 02160-4711 for tithe. May God richly bless you in Jesus' name.